So as we know, DNA carries important information from one generation to the subsequent generation. So here we discuss about the two important experiment by which we can say that yes, DNA carries heritable information from one generation to the next generation. So, first here we collect two strain of same bacteria. The name of the bacteria is Streptococcus pneumoniae. So, two closely related strain of the bacterium Streptococcus pneumoniae differ from each other. Okay, these two strains are one strain appears smooth and cause death when injected into the mice, and other appear rough and it is non-lethal. So two strain, one is called R strain, one is called R strain, and another is S strain. R strain is non-lethal, S strain is lethal. So when we injected S strain into the mice, it leads to death of that mice. But R strain does not show any pathogenic effect of that mice when we injected into that animal. So R strain is formed by the random mutations of S strain. You have to remember it. You have to memorize it that R strain is a form of S strain, and it is formed by the random mutation of the S strain. So S strain means smooth pathogenic bacterium cause pneumonia. Random mutation leads to transformation of S strain into the R strain, rough non-pathogenic mutant bacterium. This is rough non-pathogenic mutant bacterium. So it is not lethal. R strain is not lethal. Now, live, these are R strain bacterium. So live R strain cells grown in presence of either heat-killed S strain cells or cell-free extract of S strain cell. Now we have to grow the R strain cell in the presence of extract which is collected from the S strain cell, or we can incubate the R cells from R cells in the presence of heat killed S strain. We kill the S strain by applying heat. So these that are called heat killed S strain. So what happened? Now this leads to transformations of R strain into A strain. So some R strain cells are transformed to S strain cells whose daughter cells are pathogenic and cause pneumonia. So some R strain transform into the S strain and whose daughter cells show a lethal effect. Whose daughter cells are pathogenic. So we can say that there is something present inside the S cell that leads to transformations of R strain cell into the S strain cell. So we can conclude that the molecules that can carry heritable informations are present in S strain cell. Those cells may be protein, RNA, DNA, lipid, carbon, we don't know, but we know that there is something present inside the S strain cell, extract of the S strain cells that helps in the transformation of R strain to S strain, and carries the input, carries the heritable informations. So an initial experiment shows that some substrate present in A strain can change or transform the R strain into the A strain, and that this change is inherited by the subsequent generations of the bacteria. So this is the first experiment. Now the second experiment says, now in the second experiment we have to know that what is that particular molecule that helps in the transformations of arsen into arsen. What is that particular molecules that carries the information to the daughter cell. So arsen cell, now we incubate. Now first we collect the molecules like RNA, protein, DNA, lipid and carbohydrate from the arsen cell and incubate with the arsen individually. So when we incubate arsen with RNA, there is no transformations of the RNA is shown. So or remain arsen. When we incubate protein with arsen, we can get arsen. Now we incubate arsen with lipid and carbohydrate. There is no change. Even in the presence of lipid and carbohydrate, we get arsen. So these molecules do not change arsen cells, arsen of the bacteria into arsen. But when we incubate arsen with the presence of DNA which is collected from the arsen cell, we can see that some arsen transform into the arsen and their daughter, these daughter cells which is formed from that transformation are pathogenic. So these are arsen cells. So from this experiment we can easily determine that yes, the molecule or conclude that the molecule that carries the heritable information is DNA, because in the presence of DNA, arsen cells transform into the arsen cell and the daughter cells shows pathogenic effect. So the DNA which is present in the arsen cells shows a changes in the arsen cells. So the DNA which is present in the arsen cells, that DNA carries the information or heritable information to the daughter cells, to the daughter cell of the bacterium. That is why that particular daughter cell also shows lethal effect when we introduced into some organ. So this experiment in which the arsen has been incubated with the various classes of biological molecules purified from the arsen identify the active substance as DNA. So from these two experiments, we can easily determine that yes, DNA carries heritable informations from one generation to the next generations. If you like the video, please share with your friends. Thank you.